हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मिस डॉक टी. दिस इज़ डॉक्टर फरहीन, जनरल मेडिसिन रेसिडेंट, एंड टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस क्रायोग्लोबुलिनेमिक वास्कुलाइटिस. So first we'll see what are cryoglobulins. So as the name indicates, globulins means immunoglobulins and cryo means they are precipitated by cold temperatures. So cryoglobulins are immunoglobulins that are precipitated at cold temperatures. Now we'll look at the pathogenesis of cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. Hepatitis C antigen acts as a trigger against which the antibodies are produced, and these antibodies are of two types. The antibodies which are specific against hepatitis C antigen and antibodies produced against the FC segment of the immunoglobulin. So if you take the structure of an immunoglobulin, this is the FC fragment, and against this FC fragment the antibodies are produced, and these antibodies are known as rheumatoid factor, and these antibodies can be of IgG type or of IgM type. Now rheumatoid factor doesn't mean that it is specific for rheumatoid arthritis. So rheumatoid factor is just the immunoglobulins or the antibodies produced against the FC fragment of immunoglobulin. Now we'll continue with the pathogenesis. So the antigen antibody will form immune complexes which will then deposit in the blood vessels and especially involve organs like skin, kidneys and joints. So when skin is involved, because of these immune complex deposition, it leads to cutaneous vasculitis. So this cutaneous vasculitis can lead to necrotizing vasculitis or it can lead to bleeds. So necrotizing vasculitis will produce necrotic lesions or ulcers on skin, and bleeds can present with purpura, and these are especially common on the medial side of legs. So this is a picture of necrotic lesion, necrotic ulcer here, and these are the purpura. Next, when the kidneys are involved, it leads to membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis because of immune complex deposition in the glomerulus. This will then lead to renal failure. This is the histological picture of a normal glomeruli. When there is membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, then you can see immune complex deposition inside the glomeruli. So this is the histology of membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. So progression to MPGN indicates a poor prognosis. Next, when the joints are involved, it leads to arthritis. So these are the clinical features of cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. Now we'll look at the diagnosis. The first one is to demonstrate cryoprecipitates. That means when the serum is incubated at 4 degrees centigrade for 7 days, precipitates will be seen. So this is a normal serum and it is incubated at 4 degrees centigrade for 7 days, and then the immunoglobulins precipitate. And again, when it is heated back to 37 degrees centigrade, these will dissolve. The second thing is to demonstrate the rheumatoid factor, which is commonly seen in cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. And the third thing is to detect the hepatitis C RNA or anti-hepatitis C antibodies. Now we'll look at the treatment. So antivirals against hepatitis C is the first mode of treatment. And rituximab, which is anti-CD20 monoclonal antibody, is also approved for the treatment of cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. But remember, steroids worsen the disease. Unlike many other rheumatological conditions, this point is important to remember here, that steroids cannot be used here because they have shown to worsen the disease. Now we look at the prognosis. It is usually good, but it is bad if the patient has an underlying renal or liver dysfunction, like if the patient is a known CKD or CLD or alcoholic. Similarly, progression to membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis indicates a bad prognosis. Now, what are the points to remember to solve an MCQ? The first thing is, there is an association with hepatitis C antigen. There may be a positive rheumatoid factor. There is cutaneous vasculitis, so lesions are seen especially on the medial side of leg. And there is membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. Now, we'll see some other conditions which can cause cryoglobulinemia. That means immunoglobulins that can be precipitated at cold temperatures can be seen with hepatitis C, which is most common, and also in multiple myeloma, lymphoproliferative disorders, and sometimes the cause is unknown, idiopathic, which is known as essential mixed cryoglobulinemia. Now we'll look at some other conditions associated with a rheumatoid factor. So first, what is a rheumatoid factor? This is the antibody directed against the Fc fragment of an immunoglobulin. So suppose this is the immunoglobulin structure and this is the Fc fragment. And now this is an immunoglobulin M, IgM. And if this IgM is directed against the Fc fragment of the immunoglobulin G, then it is known as a rheumatoid factor. So an antibody that is IgM or IgG against the Fc fragment of an immunoglobulin is known as a rheumatoid factor. So it is seen with rheumatoid arthritis, cryoglobulinemic vasculitis, Sjogren syndrome, systemic lupus erythematosus, dermatomyositis, and mixed connective tissue disorders. So these are some conditions where you can see a positive rheumatoid factor. So remember these. Now we'll look at the differences between polyarthritis nodosa and cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. Both of them have almost a similar pathogenesis and maybe a similar presentation, but now we'll look at the differences. In polyarthritis nodosa, hepatitis B antigen acts as a trigger, whereas in cryoglobulinemic vasculitis, hepatitis C antigen acts as a trigger. PAN involves kidney, skin and musculoskeletal system especially, and it is the same even with cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. The musculoskeletal involvement will have arthralgias and myalgias in both of them. The main points to differentiate both of them is to look at the kidneys and skin. So renal involvement in polyarthritis nodosa presents with hematuria because of microaneurysms, whereas renal involvement in cryoglobulinemic vasculitis presents with MPGN, membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis. Skin involvement in PAN presents with livedo reticularis or Raynaud's phenomenon, and skin involvement in cryoglobulinemic vasculitis presents with some necrotizing lesions or purpura, especially on the medial side of legs. Now, if he wants to ask some image-based questions, then some clues favoring the diagnosis of PAN include a renal angio showing microaneurysms, a picture of Raynaud's phenomenon, or a picture of livedo reticularis. And similarly, if he wants to ask about cryoglobulinemic vasculitis, then a picture of MPGN, membranoproliferative glomerulonephritis, or purpura, or necrotic lesions on the leg can be shown. It is important to remember these differences. Now, immune complexes formed because of hepatitis B antigen produce the vasculitic syndrome polyarthritis nodosa. And similarly, immune complexes formed because of hepatitis C antigen produce the vasculitic syndrome known as cryoglobulinemic vasculitis. Now, here's a question for you. So can you tell me a condition where immune complexes produce vasculitis, especially common in children of 4 to 7 years of age group? So again, this topic is really important for the PG entrance examination. We'll discuss it in our next video. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it. Let's meet again with another new topic. Till then, just take care, be happy, and stay safe.